So we will later we will talk about glucuronic acid also. Glucuronic acid also. So this is also one of the monosaccharide, acid monosaccharide. Now we will talk about this UDP glucuronate here. I have shown here bilirubin and drugs. You can see here UDP glucuronate. Now UDP glucuronic acid, as I told you here, this is the product because of oxidation of glucose here. So oxidation of glucose will produce UDP glucuronate. And this is a very, very, very important role of this glucuronic acid. You know, a very important role is metabolism of drug. And you know metabolism of drug, I told you, if you remember, stage one, phase one reaction. Phase one reaction. Phase one reaction is done by cytochrome 450 system. We have done, I told you to remember the membrane attached, the mitochondrial, this endoplasmic reticulum attached membrane attached. This cytochrome 450, millions of, I told you to remember, millions of this cytochrome 450 will be in there. And this will do what? To drug, this will do hydroxylation reaction. Utilizing what? NADPH, NADPH and oxygen. It will do hydroxylation reaction. This is phase one reaction. And this phase one, after phase one, phase two reaction is done by UDP glucuronate. So phase two reaction is addition of this glucuronic acid to this OH group. Here glucuronic acid is added. So this glucuronic acid addition means it will become very much soluble. The insoluble drugs now become soluble here by through this process, phase one and phase two reaction. First hydroxylation and this glucuronation. So see, I'm teaching you in other way basis of this drug metabolism also through this all biochemistry. So drug metabolism, xenobiotic metabolism, this xenobiotic metabolism resembles bilirubin metabolism. These both are very similar in metabolism. So bilirubin metabolism conjugation will require this glucuronic acid. Drug metabolism, you can see steroid metabolism, drug metabolism will also require this. And not only this, you know, we have done in glycoprotein. Glycoprotein has sugar acid. Glycoprotein, it is actually glycosaminoglycan, proteoglycan. Proteoglycan, glycosaminoglycan, we have done. It is a long chain of disaccharide with sugar acid plus sugar amine. So this is long chain of this disaccharide, sugar acid and sugar amine we have done in carbohydrate, in MD1 only. We have done in carbohydrate MD1, the heteropolysaccharide. So this glycosaminoglycan also require this sugar acid. That is glucuronic acid. From glucuronic acid only, this through epimerization, epimerase, action of epimerase, UDP glucose will change into UDP iduronate. And you have studied about iduronate, the enzyme that is deficient in Hurler syndrome, iduronate. So this is the same thing. Iduronate is the same as glucuronic acid. Little bit difference is there only, epimerase. So otherwise, this is nothing but glucuronic acid. So you already know this iduronic acid is present in proteoglycan. So these are the functions you can see of iduronic acid. Now we have done these two, UDP glucose, iduronic acid, uronic acid, okay, uronic acid metabolism. So this is called uronic acid because the last sixth carbon is oxidized. That is why it is called uronic. Do you know there are two types of acid? One is gluconic acid. We have studied in hexose monophosphate shunt. Here in gluconic acid, carbon number one is oxidized. When we talk about glucuronic acid, means last carbon, carbon number six is oxidized. So that is the basic difference. Gluconic acid and glucuronic acid. Remember that difference.